So welcome to The Surge. This is an upcoming game that's currently in development with Deck 13 Interactive, and it's all about melee combat. They contacted me and asked if I wanted to give it a go. So yes, this is a sponsored video, and they've asked me to leave a link to the game's website in the description so you can go and check it out if you want to. But basically, today we're going to be going over the basics of the game, the combat, the crafting, and a few other things. And the game's described as like this sci-fi, melee-focused RPG. So I'm really hoping for some rather brutal animations.
Have a nice day, Warren.
Well, thank you very much. So, I've explored this level a little bit already, just so I can get myself familiar with the game, but I'm going to show you guys how the combat works in this game. So, at the moment, I've got, like, a rusty piece of metal as my weapon, which doesn't sound very good, but it's alright. And I'll show you how the combat works. I'm going to go this way, because this is where one of the robots is, and he'll stand up in a minute. I thought you were going to stand up. Sleeping on the job. There we go. Just had to wake him up a little bit. So, you can lock onto him. I've done that with middle mouse button. And here you can see the different body parts that are on him. Now, if it's blue, that means he's unarmored in that position. So, I will do more damage to him and take him down quicker. However, if I hit him anywhere that's gold, or that yellowy colour, I will gain, like, scrap or parts so that I can craft different body parts from my own sort of exosuit that I'm wearing. So, tell you what, to begin with, I'll show you just how to do this unarmored. So, hit him in the head a few times, and then I can finish him off. Boom. Smack-a-rooney, head comes off. Utterly beautiful. So that was the first one. And then, the second guy, now he's got an unarmored head, an unarmored left arm, a right arm, right leg, so that all the left side of his body is unarmored, but the right side has got something that maybe I want. So yeah, damage and cut weapons and armored body parts to get new equipment. So here we go. Let's take this. It'll take a little bit longer, but I should be able to get something out of him. Yeah, if I'm damaging the body parts, and then I can finish him off. That was nice. So I cut his arm off specifically so that I can take what he's got, I believe. If you go over here, a wrecked Lynx arm gear. So I can pick that up. And I've now got one of those in my inventory. And then I think that might mean that I can... Does that mean I can equip it? Can I do that yet? I'm not sure I can yet. But anyway, this guy here has a power core on him, so he can do more damage, just like I've now got a power core. Yeah, he's not happy with me. Let me just lock on to him. Do you know what? I'm going to go for an unarmored attack this one. There we go, nice slide and hit. Now you can change which limb you want to attack mid. So here I can go for now for his right arm if I wanted to. Oh, that was quite a bad hit on me. I'm not close enough to him. I could have blocked that, but I'm going to go in for the finish up. And I'm going to take, I think, his right arm again. I'm not sure. I might have damaged that too much to be able to take it. Now, as you can see, in the top left-hand corner, you've got health, stamina, and energy. Now, my health has only got 4 bars on it. The energy goes down. So as you do more melee combat, it means that you'll do more damage as you go along. And, here we go. Let's bring this guy out here. I'm going to go for your right arm. Get around behind you. Just finish this guy off nice and quickly. Boom. Complete takedown. Right, I've got 20 seconds to go and get the scrap that I lost by dying earlier on. Right, let's get your left arm, buddy. Just take you down nice and quick. 10 seconds. Finish him off. Yes, another 25 seconds. And now I can pick up this, which I lost earlier, which was all of my lost scrap. So 811 scrap I was about to lose because I died. But the more melee combat you do and the more damage you do, you'll see that the energy bar up the top there stays high. And then the health bar is something you have to top up manually. This guy wants a piece of the action. I'm just going to bring him into a more open area, actually, because... Unless he's... Yeah, he's not going to attack me now. tried to drag him out of it. Like, this guy is fully armored, so there's not much I can do. I'm just going to hit him in the head because he doesn't seem to realize that there's a door right there. Now, I have to be careful because if he hits me, I need to be very aware of how much damage he can do in one hit. Because my weapon is not that great. Oh, here we go. I can pick something up. So I actually acquired his headgear there, which is nice. He could do way more damage with a weapon like that. See that glowing thing over there? That does way more damage than my, what looks like an axe or something. So you have to be really careful of your health. And if you need to, you can top it up by pressing F. That's one of the little implants I've got in my exosuit. And now that the exosuit has got power, I can actually use those implants, whereas I couldn't before. So, right, there's three here, and I don't want to draw too much attention, but I'm going to go for this guy first. Hopefully, take this guy before he retaliates. Hit him while he's down. Oh, see there? He's done a lot of damage. I'll top it back up. Going for the final here and finish the guy off. Beautiful. If that door wasn't in the way, man. Tell you what, we'll try and get into a more open area. Hopefully, this guy's fully armored as well. Let's go for the left leg. Yeah, there you go. Nice takedown. Oh, he swung his thing around and hit me. You can block attacks as well. So if I block, look. You can block with Q, I believe. Oh, he did 41 damage. Oh, that was close. One more hit and he would have had me. And finish. Oh, no. Finish him. Nice. Complete takedown. So this guy, he has given me... Oh, I got some proficiency on my one-handed baton of death. Schematic unlocked for the Lynx leg gear. Now we're going to make our way through. So I've got 3/4 health. I'm going to attempt this one. Right, has he got any unarmored? No. Now, I don't know. Let's get the right leg. Now, if I can continue to parry all of his shots, he won't be able to retaliate properly. Rather than him attacking me, I just simply attack him. But as you can see there, I'm dead. I'm going to have to go back through and fight these guys again. So I decided to upgrade my character a bit. I crafted a few things that I picked off other players. And now, hopefully, this should give me a little bit more of an advantage against some of these ones, because getting in here, the four of them lock onto you, and without any extra gear, it can be a little bit daunting. So, there you go, 27 damage there. Extra. Thing is, I've got unprotected body parts still as well. Come on. There we go. Finish him. See, I've still got an unprotected left arm and left arm and body. I've got stuff on everything else, which is nice. So this guy should go down pretty quickly. There we go. This is actually, like I said, much harder than it looks, because you've got to be aware of where these guys have got armor, where you haven't got armor, and then sort of play off each other the best you can. So this guy here hasn't got any armor on his body. We'll attack that nice and quickly. See, there you go. 3 hits to the body and it takes him down. Wow. That was beautiful. But now we've cleared those guys out, we're in a much better position now because we've got lots of extra health. So just going to come in and... Oh, I didn't get what I was looking for. It's fine. Oh, he hit me in the body. Oh, he got me again. Going to heal up. Finish him. Oh my god. Straight through the leg. Takes it off. I'll take that. I need headgear. I need some headgear and some body gear. So I think we're going to have to attack these guys in the head. Oh, good. This guy doesn't have any armor on his head. But we'll take him down nice and quickly, I guess. And oh wow, I didn't even need a finishing move. I thought I was gonna need that. How do I get up there? I'm assuming you have to walk around to get that. Can I open this? No, we still can't open that. Okay. Right, this guy... Oh, he hasn't got any armor on his body. That was a mistake. Should have armored up your body, mate. And the swing and the finish. Beautiful. So I didn't get any gear off those guys, but I have now cleared them out, which means I can get to the next part. Got anything over here? Oh, another player. What are you doing in there, buddy? Oh, you got stuck right in the corner. Complete takedown, though. Complete takedown. Can we get up there? Oh, I thought I was going to do it. Right. So, this door can't be opened from this terminal. Use the terminal on the opposite side. Well, I can't do that because... Ah, here we go. This door is the one you open. Overcharge it. Here we go. This is pretty cool. Boom. Door open. This melee combat is pretty comprehensive, I've got to say. I quite enjoy this. Now I can open this side of the door. There are a couple of flying robots on this side. That. Yeah, they're poking me to death. Oh, the double hit there. And the takedown. Beautiful. Love having this arm. This is awesome. Right, so we're on the main assembly line still. Make our way through. See what's going on here. What have we got? I thought there'd be like little enemies off to the side and stuff. It doesn't look like there is. Sure, there's going to be something through here. Yeah, there is. Oh, right leg. Oh, he took 51 health off of me. Finish him. And he took another 32 health from me as well. Well, I've got a lot of tech scrap, actually. I'll tell you what. I'll show you what we do with the tech scrap. We're this far forwards, and now that I've opened all these doors, I don't have to go around that massive loop every single time. I can just sort of... So this is the starting point here. I can just sort of cut back this way. So, obviously, you can go into your inventory and you can apply all the different things to your body. But at the moment, I haven't crafted any of those things. So what you need to do is go back into your sort of, like, Home Depot section here. And you can go to the gear assembly. And you can choose the gear that you want to craft. So here, to craft this piece of headgear... It's going to cost me 537 scrap, and I've got 2,498. So, let's craft that. There you go. Now I've got some headgear. Have I got any body gear? No, I haven't got any body gear at all. I really need to get some body gear. That's arm gear. Leg gear. Have I got anything else I can put on my arm? Can we craft that? There you go. We'll craft that as well. Which is a Lynx arm gear. And now, the only thing I haven't got left is my body. So, and then if we go back into our inventory, I can apply the headgear. Can I? Oh no, I can't apply that headgear. God damn it. But, have I got left arm gear? Can't apply that. Can't apply any of it. God damn it. Oh, I may have got only right arm gear rather than left. That doesn't explain why I can't do the headgear. I'm not sure why I can't do that, but... Not to worry. But at least you can now understand how you craft things and build your way up through the levels. And each of these parts has, like, different marks to them, so they do, like, different amounts of damage and things like that. Now that I've come back to the start, you'll see that I'm able to destroy these guys fairly quickly, which is good. But I've also regened most of my health. Actually, no, that's not true. Wow, that was quite a damaging hit. 25, and then finish him. There we go. So I've got nearly full health, and I've got two refreshes on my health as well, which is nice. So, let's get back to it. We'll take down a few more enemies, and then I think we'll call it a day. There he is. He knows I'm here. Just wait till the last second to... Or if you stand in the gas, it damages you. I didn't realize that. Finish him. Oh, yeah. I don't think... There you go. Yeah, if you go in that gas, it really does damage you. That's not good. Right, I've not got much health here. Oh, god damn it. Oh, wow. It's a quad, a triple quadrator or something. Oh. Oh. How does this even work? Destroyed. There's another one. Every time you hit them, I think it powers down what it is that they're trying to do. These are fairly easy little ones to kill. And they're just sort of to keep you entertained as you work your way along. You have to go through that gap there. Or is it in here? It's in here. Gotta go up the stairs. Right, half health. There's one. Oh, 38 damage straight to the head. And again. And one final one. Take down. Didn't even need the animation for that. Right. Let's see what we've got here. Only a little bit of health left, but we've got two refreshes, so we should be okay. Alright. Into the next zone. There's the quadrator. Oh, I didn't get it. And I'm down. Oh, that's a shame. We got pretty far there, actually. So that's pretty much the basics of The Surge. Seems like a really cool game, and the melee combat feels, at least, from these earlier robots over here, working your way through to some of the more powerful ones. It definitely feels like there's a knack to knowing when to parry, when to go for it, and I like the fact that you can target different body parts as well, and then that leads to you sort of like gearing up your soldier specifically. I really like that idea. I think that's great. Don't like it when two robots come and attack you at the same time, but hey-ho, what can we do about that? We'll try and kill him anyway. 30 damage, yes. Yeah. So, if you want to check this game out a little bit more, then you're more than welcome to. There is a link down in the description that will take you to the game's website. All the information's on there. It's coming out on the PC, Xbox One, and PS4 in May. So, I think just over a month from now. And, well, if you like melee combat games, and something that's a little bit different from the games that are out there right now in this sort of sci-fi, sort of arena-style game, then definitely you guys should go and check this one out. But thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.